Hello, and welcome back to another episode of ARK. Crap. Well, that was not supposed to happen. Great. Is arcing. There we go. Now I can just click and it'll fill up. So I got another Sarco and I tried out the breeding thing. And now we have a baby Sarco. And I was told you had to, like, feed these like crazy, but it's not. Food isn't draining as much as I thought it would. Like, people were saying, skip the naming, do that later, because they'll, like, starve to death while you're naming them. Apparently, it can only hold 0.4 pounds right now. I've also heard things say that this goes up really fast. Doesn't seem to be going that way right now. Because, look in here. This is what I had prepared. I had so much stuff prepared for this. And it is not eating as much as I thought it would. Also, on the beach, it apparently takes 3 or 4 torches, depending if it's day or night, to tame a Sarco. This is 60 degrees right now, which I've seen it get up to 70 and down to 50, so that range. And also, this stack was a full 100 thatch, so by the time it took this torch to burn through 95, it tamed. 94, 95. So, I don't know what to call this. Oh, well, that bar is not going up. I also read that once they get past, it can hold 5. Oh, it can hold even more. Hold 7 now. Okay, but I read once it gets past this small stage, it can start eating out of the trough, so I'll be able to leave it alone. Whoa. But I got another Sarco, and we already had Rosie. I was like, what's a guy version of the name Rosie? Like, Ross? I don't know. Anyway. Oh yeah, if you couldn't already tell, I filled up my hotbar because if I double click, it can hold 9 now. If I double click, it'll try to put into an inventory, like an animal or a chest. And if it can't, or you're just in your own inventory, it'll put it in the nearest hotbar, regardless if it has something already there. So, as you saw earlier in the video, I was filling up my hotbar with the different stuff. Okay, so this is, I guess the weight is going up pretty fast, and it is eating a lot more than other dinos, but I did get way more than I actually needed. Oh, it can hold 11 now. Oh, I guess it shows the weight right here. And each meat is 0.1. So when this hits 1.2, I'll be able to put in 12. I have no idea what these stats like actually mean. Like, this out of 400, is that just Is it just going to be their health as baby? And does it go up when they tame? Or is that the most health it's going to have for whatever level it is? It's level 24. That sucks. I guess, yeah, Rosie's 24 and Ross is 50, so it took the lower level. Oh, this is only like one pixel. This is gonna suck. Oh, I got this egg around 3 or 4 o'clock. It is now 7 o'clock. Yeah, so it took like 3 or 4 hours for the egg to hatch. So that was to feel like a huge waste of time if these are gonna be its stats. I mean, the Sarcos. Apparently, it takes. Ooh, snake. Apparently, it takes the. The stats when it was tamed, not what you've put into it. Where'd it go? What? How did it get it so fast? Oh, it's following me. Okay, here, come back over here. Come on. Man, it's slow. I guess that is the walking speed, because it's not at a distance of the running speed. Okay, yeah, good enough. Hold 17 now. Let's do a bit better. Here, you stay there. And don't wander around. Hey. Hey. Okay, because it has to follow me, or else it'll just wander off. Oh yeah, I also read, there was a guide or whatever that said, make sure you have stuff near it on, like, not hostile, and that you don't have, like, turrets and stuff. Because they don't start in your tribe, they start as claimable. Wow, this sucks. Oh, I can hold full stack now. This is gonna take forever. It's like one pixel. I already have to cut off the first, like, 5 minutes of this episode. Because I had it just filming the egg, waiting for it to hatch. Okay, well, while we're just sitting here, if you put this on 720p in YouTube, and maybe full screen, I don't know. Probably look better in the little window, because that's closer to native or whatever. But I put post-processing to epic. If I turn it to low, that's what I had it on before. And if I turn it back up to epic, can you see a difference? Because in this scene, I can't, but in, like, near the house, it adds a little bit more shadow, so I don't know if that's really worth it. Now, for anti-aliasing, if I have it on low, it looks like this, which stuff that's really close looks really good. Okay, I need to feed this again. Oh, good, dang it. What was there? Oh. Why did that stack? great. Here, just fill up my inventory. I'll just take some berries. Worry about that. Okay, so back to this. What did I have it on? Okay, I have it on low. And stuff that's close, like the parasaur right there, looks really good. But the leaves, way off in the distance, are kind of broken. And if I turn it to epic, then the leaves in the background are actually still pretty broken. And then I guess the parasaur is kinda alright, but then the ankylo right behind him looks like someone smeared Vaseline all over that part of my screen. So I don't like it. So I had it on medium, which actually the ankylo still looks really bad. I don't know, maybe I should just leave it on low. Today I asked slightly a bunch, like, does this look better, does that look better? Now the ankylo doesn't look like it has any kind of blur, it looks nice and clear. So I prefer anti-aliasing off. And let's check it's a moment. Probably should have put a door on that pen. Oh, that didn't work. That's good, it can hold 31 now. It's still only at like 3 pixels. This is gonna take forever. And those trees are still flashing like crazy. Now that flashing is solved by distance field shadowing, turning that off. So now the trees look like crap in the distance, but they aren't flashing. So that's what I had before, is I had that off. Now also, if you saw distance field inclusion and screen spacing and occlusion, those two, if I turn them on, right now, I'm getting 30 FPS, 29-30, it's going back and forth. If I turn those off, things look a little brighter, and I'm getting 32 FPS, 32-31. I guess that's not too big of a hit, but I don't know what changed. Wish it was like a hotkey, I could just turn them on and off without going into the menu. I guess there's like a little bit of shadow that got added to the ankylo. But now I'm getting 28 FPS, 27. I don't know. The settings in this game are a mess. I really should be able to put everything on maximum. But nope. I'm playing at console stats, pretty much. Which is 720p, 30fps. So if it's running like this, my computer, that's a white one, I don't care. If it's running like this on my computer, there's no way they're going to be able to make it look this good on consoles. It's going to be like garbage. Actually, let's mess with some of the presets. So I have everything pretty much turned up in the lower four boxes here. So let's do low. One FPS. Okay, wow, that looks so bad. So bad. And I'm getting 36 FPS. Changing from all epic to all low gave me 6 FPS boost. Oh, I went down to 28, 30, 34, 36. Okay, yeah. And then let's try medium. That's still, it's super blurry. 31, 30, 36. Okay. Let's try high. That's still really blurry. 24. What? 32, 33. Oh man, it has motion blur. That looks so bad. Yeah, so 33. Then all epic. Oh, 22. What? I just had it on all epic. Oh, it's ground clutter. Get out of here. Resolution scale up. Motion blur, I hate that. So 28, 27, 28. Yeah, there's like no way this is gonna run on consoles. Let me get some more meat. This, let me scoop that over. What was I gonna say? It's a turtle. That looks pretty fuzzy. Is there still something? Oh, I need to turn those off. Yeah, still 30. So I don't know. There's a difference of, like, 6 FPS in that scene between low and epic. So I guess I will continue to stuff food into this, and I will be right back. Okay, apparently I did not have enough meat. So also, I stopped at last recording around like 7:30-ish. It's now 9 o'clock. This is not worth it. It is 10% done. 10%. Oh, god dang it, I didn't mute mumble. Hold on. Okay. So, this is 3:30 weight, and it's now at 33. And I read on the thing that at 10 to 50% it will feed from a feeding trough. I'm gonna see if that's true. Now, I'm pretty sure it is in range of both feeding troughs, so it might be eating all the cooked meat out of the other one. But I did, instead of having it follow me around, I tethered it to Big Red. Let's scoot it over there a bit. Oh yeah, it does have the feeding trough symbol. But holy crap. This is not worth it. See, the food is going down. 40, 39, 80. Okay, it did spike up, so it is using the feeding trough now. So I can put way more meat in this trough and then just not worry about it. But this is just not worth it. So because it's so not worth it, I am tearing down this, the breeding pen thing that I made. Oh, god dang it. Let me put this away. Okay, so, and now these guys can actually fit outside. They actually couldn't fit through the door, so I had to ramp them over this. But this is the like breeding area I didn't show in the first 20 minutes of the episode, which I'm trying to keep this short. Actually, I'll put you over here as defense. Then Rosie can go back to her normal spot. It's in range, yeah, it's in range, okay. Oh yeah, I did name the saber Catsy. Also, I named the Ankylo Spikeout. Spike? Spike's the new one. Right. So in taming this, up to getting from laying to the egg up to this 10% mark, it has been, I don't know, 6 hours. You know how long it took me? Wait. Oh, this is Rosie. I put Ross over there. But you know how long it took me to get Ross? Like an hour, maybe. No, not even that, because I went and found Prime. So it took me like 20 minutes. This is not worth it. This is so not worth it. I don't know what they were thinking. I mean, the taming speed is sped up on the server. So that... dang it, let go of the wrong buttons. This is hard. Push to talk. I'm using C, which I'm using my thumb for, and then E to open up this, but now I'm using my mouse push to talk, so it's a lot easier. It's not breaking, there we go. So screw this breeding thing. It's not good. I think for something like dodos, the small dinos, it's a like 5-10 minutes maybe, but it was supposed to be a lot faster, and this was supposed to be a couple hours. It's been way more than a couple hours. It's been like 6. Anyway, I'll finish tearing. Oh yeah, when I was manually putting the stuff in, I just put these engrams on my bar to stop meat from going there and to not have something spoil. I was gonna put thatch there, but apparently I can't put thatch in your bar. But I just went into here and you just drag these on. And if you want to craft that, you just hit the button for it. Also, if you hold it down, it'll tell you what you need, but that does for normal items as well. For how much you need to repair it. But also, if you have one of those things, and it's just, it's like the see-through thing, you can also hit that and it'll craft another one. But whatever, this is not worth it. Don't breed dinos. It sucks. But I'll see you guys next time. Bye.